this is a 1952 D-28 that has been through the ringer and back. And just take a look at the top on this guitar here. I'm going to bring it up here to the camera. Just take a look at all those cracks. This top is just absolutely loaded with cracks. I think a lot of people would say, oh, you know, I'm going to replace the top on this. But my impression is always to try to save the original top. Because, yeah, sure, you could put a piece of Adirondack spruce on here, but you're not going to get this many years of wear. And besides that, look at the back and sides on this. Full of cracks. Bad, bad, bad finish wear back on here. And I'm sure that's how the owner got this guitar, is because it was in poor shape. Look at these cracks here. I'm not sure how good they are. Yeah, they are. Now you can see them. This thing has really been through it. So I got it. I've known this guitar for quite a while, really. And it's a funny story. The owner one time got to play with a, kind of a famous bluegrass guitar player. And the owner could not get the guitar in tune. And he thought it was just, he said it was like a nightmare. You know, here you are playing with your, with one of your heroes. You can't get your guitar in tune. So years and years went by, and he finally asked me to work on it. I finally got good enough to work on it, maybe. And the first thing I found out was that the bridge was out of position by almost a quarter of an inch. That was really startling to me. I mean, I knew that the bridge had been shaved, but I had no idea when I played it previously that it was that far out of position. But when I put my ruler on it, the bridge was way out. So, and it had been shaved, you know. So the first thing I did was make a new bridge and get it in the right place, get it to the right height, do all that stuff, do a neck reset on it, do a full fret job on it. When I was doing the neck reset, I discovered that the neck block was actually cracked in half. And neck block looks like this, you know, where the dovetail is. There's a piece of wood. This whole entire section of it broke off at the dovetail. So when I pulled the neck off, the neck block here just came apart. Well, that was interesting. So I glued that up, and I realized that this crack right here actually ran through the neck block. So the neck block at one point had broken and caused this crack to occur. Wow, that was a mess. So fixed that up, fixed up the dovetail inside here because, you know, pieces of wood were just coming off all over the place. Got all that glued back up. I used Tight Bond 3 for this because it's got a much higher heat resistance than some other glues. And so if I ever have to take the neck off again, hopefully the neck block will stay together because I use fish glue for the dovetail itself. And this should come apart fairly easily. The Tight Bond 3 will stay together. So got all that glued together. Got the bridge back on. Put a new bridge plate in it because the previous bridge plate was just cracked in half. And it was worthless. Every single back brace was loose on this guitar. I glued every one of them up. Also, while I had the neck off, I noticed the cracks running alongside the fingerboard here. And I had previously noticed like a little hump going on right there. And what I discovered then is I suspected when I got the neck off, I discovered that it was cracked right here and it was not glued at all. So the wood was just moving like this. So I pulled the popsicle brace out and made my little trapezoid brace that runs from the neck block up to the sound hole brace, and it goes in an angle like this. So it wedges up in between the neck block and the sound hole brace. This one, I actually used two pieces of wood and I glued them cross-grained to each other to make a, basically a piece of plywood. I really wanted some serious strength under this neck. So I glued that in there, got that all solid and fixed up, put it back together. Did a full refret on it with Evo frets. These are the gold fret wire, which have a real subtle look, you know. That's not really, it's not a vicious gold look at all. You have to really kind of look at them. They wear extremely good, and they're in really nice frets. I like them so much better than, well, I don't like them better than stainless steel all the time, but they are my favorite fret wire. I did a new bone nut on it, put some pins in it, did a pickguard on it. The owner's coming to pick it up tomorrow. So it's a 52 D-28. That means it's Brazilian rosewood. And, you know, you could take this guitar out and play it anywhere now. I mean, it's got cracks galore, but they're all cleated up. They're all nice and tight and solid. You'd never have to worry about scratching this guitar, that's for sure. So here it is. It's kind of fun working on it. And obviously the fingerboard has been replaced too. There's no, I didn't do that work, someone else did. There's no markers on it. At first, I thought that the fingerboard had not been trimmed, and that's why the bridge was off. But as I got to measuring it more and working more on the guitar, I discovered that, no, it was the bridge that was just out of position. It must have come off and somebody must have glued it back on. I don't know. At some point. You can see the scar in front of it right here. You can see the scar right here where the bridge had come up. It used to come up a lot farther. And I guess it was just an oversized bridge. My bridge is more crap for 50s. It's thinner this way. It's the right dimensions. It fits good, so let's play a little bit more on it. It's a bright, snappy guitar. I mean, non-scallop braces. I didn't see any scalloping to it. Just, you know, got the bridge plate cracked, and that's it. It's got lots of volume. Really loud. Chunky neck on it. I assume this is the original neck. Wow, it's got some heft to it. And whoever put the fingerboard on left it just a little bit wide, so it's not an 11/16 inch more, it's more like a 23/32. It actually is right in between. These are 23/32 at the nut. It's a chunky neck. It feels a lot like an LSV. You know, big V back here and chunky, so. No. D-28.